Very good morning to all the children of class plus 1B. We have already discussed about the particulars related to class. Now let's start the chapter. The address term 2. Fine, though it is mentioned in term 1, but whatever we will be doing is included in term 2 now. So the address, the name of the chapter in itself tells us that we are going to read something related to the address of a house. Fine. But why that address is important, that we have to see. So basic characters are Mrs. S, daughter of Mrs. S, and Mrs. Darling. Fine. So these three characters are there throughout the chapter. Rest here and there you will get to know, but these are the main characters or protagonists, those who will be playing important role. Clear? Then now, while talking about the theme of the chapter, it is basically set. The background of this chapter is war. Then when war-like circumstances happen, war does not only destroy the geographical conditions, or it does not only destroy the houses, it destroys the emotions of the people. It breaks them mentally also. Find that how suddenly when we get to know that you have to leave this place, You ask your grandparents or grand-grandparents, they have stories to tell us that when India-Pakistan war happened, how they had to leave home, how we are so attached to my bed, my almira, my clothes, fine? Everything is so, we are so emotionally attached. Suddenly we have to leave everything. Whatever they could collect were jewelry and money or few eatables, they carried and they had to leave. And with very difficult circumstances, they reached to a new place, India. And how they tried to find a new place. Kahiyon ko achha sa ghar mila, kahiyon ko nahi mila. Some people had to remain on roads, hungry for so many days. So a person gets physical torture, mental torture, emotional torture. Fine. So war or impact of war is depicted in this story, The Address. Actually, Mrs. S and daughter of Mrs. S, they are the victims of war. Fine. And when they had to change their address, they reached to some other place because of war-like circumstances. And when daughter of Mrs. S, when she was young at that time, they have not mentioned the age here. So you can consider, suppose she's of your age and she has to leave that address where she was residing with her mother. And after many years, when her mother was no more, when Mrs. S was no more, she had nostalgia. She started missing her memories of her mother. You know, sometimes we are so attached with the object, like you, this object is given by my mother, this was given by my grandfather, and the person is no more with us, we get attached to that object only. So she wanted to relish those memories and she wanted to get back to that address. So address is 42 Marconi Street, that you have to remember. That is mentioned in the chapter, but you have to remember this address. Okay, yahan pe macaroni mat likh dena, bachche likh dete hote hain. 42 Marconi Street. Macaroni lagta hai na, agar nahi padhenge to. That is a reminder to you all. Fine. This is the address where she wants to get back and where Mrs. Darling is living now. And she is acquainted to them. So first theme is impact of war. Second theme is that how people change. How they change with the change of the circumstance. When daughter of Mrs. S was a child, she would see that Mrs. Darling was an acquaintance to her mother. Acquaintance means jaan pehchaan ka. She was not the best friend, but she would visit her house. Mrs. Darling used to come to Mrs. S's house. And whenever she would come, she would take one object from their house. Main ye le jaati hu. I will take care of it. Because war-like circumstances are prevailing. Every time she would visit, she would take, okay, this cutlery I'm taking, this wash I'm taking, I'll take care of it, this bag I'm taking. So many objects she took away, but she never returned it back. And daughter was too young to understand, but she gets irritated with this. She told her mother also, but her mother was very nice lady. she believed in that stranger, that acquainted lady. Fine. And then daughter, when wanted to feel her mother after years, she wanted to visit that place, 42 Marconi Street. She goes there and she thought, when I will enter my house, I will see the things of my mother and all. Surprisingly, the lady who opens the door is Mrs. Dorling. And she does not open the door properly. She just opens half door. And through that view only, daughter of Mrs. S, she was able to perceive that she was wearing a green colored cardigan. Now, let me tell you, when I say, okay, imagine your mother, imagine your sister. So there's a particular dress aapke mind mein aayegi. Because there are particular dresses, chahe aapke paas n number of dresses hai, but aapki mother, aapki jo ghar pe family members hai, they wear a particular dress jo unko comfortable hote hai. So 4 times a week even they wear, 3 times a week they wear. Fine, that you recall that person, particular person with that dress only. So there was a green colored cardigan which her mother would wear. Mrs. Dorling was wearing that. And daughter was quite shocked to see that she's wearing my mother's cardigan. And how did she, firstly she thought, okay, it belongs to her only. But then she noticed the wooden buttons on it. So no, so every dress has a particular trait. Ki kaise uski pehchan karenge hum? So wooden buttons were there. She noticed it. But Mrs. Dorling straight away did not recognize, because she's grown up also and she was hesitating. Kuch aapne galat kiya hota hai, that you know, chor ki daadi mein tinka, that you know that I have done something wrong. She was not opening the door. Daughter was very disheartened that how I could not enter the address. I came from far off place sitting in a train and I reached here, and daughter will be, you know, lurking between past and present. जब वो आ रही है ना एड्रेस पे, रास्ते में आप कंफ्यूज मत होना, बिकॉज इन दिस चैप्टर शी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट हर चाइल्डहुड, शी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द प्रेजेंट मोमेंट ऑल्सो. सो द चैप्टर इज लाइक अ काइंड ऑफ स्विचिंग बिटवीन प्रेजेंट एंड पास्ट. इज इट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? वी आर गोइंग टू रीड इट नाउ. आई हैव गिवन यू द बेसिक इंट्रोडक्शन, इम्पैक्ट ऑफ वॉर. सो द माइन्यूट डिटेल्स यू शुड अंडरस्टैंड. ओके ऑल ऑफ यू ऑनलाइन चिल्ड्रन, इज इट क्लियर? सेंड मी फीडबैक. चलिए लेट्स स्टार्ट. पेज नंबर 10. किसी का थम्स अप नहीं आया मुझे अभी तक. जपन, ख्याति, हर्षप्रीत, हनूर, अंजलि, इश्नूर, एवरीवन, आई एम चेकिंग वेदर यू आर देयर. यस, डू यू स्टिल नो मी? आई आस्क्ड. सो बिफोर आई स्टार्ट रीडिंग, देयर इज वन पैराग्राफ. दिस शॉर्ट स्टोरी इज अ पॉइग्नेंट अकाउंट ऑफ अ डॉटर who goes in search of her mother's belongings after the war in Holland. So underline this, war in Holland. Please bring your books tomorrow, okay? If you do not have the books, you just listen. I'll not be running up. That's why I spent good time on introduction. Ki aaj zyada read nahi karenge, because most of you are not having the books. So this story will be telling us about the daughter goes in search of mother's belongings after war in Holland. When she finds them, the objects evoke memories of her earlier life. So when she saw all those objects, she started getting feelings of her childhood, that how I spent my life. However, she decides to leave them all behind and resolves to move on. But hota kya hai, when she was waiting for that moment, that when will I get to see the objects of my mother, she covered the distance, she came from long passage to reach that place. But when she reaches that place, she moved on. She did not look at those objects. Why? Can anyone tell me? Jis moment ke liye she has been waiting for so long, when that moment comes, she did not like it at all. What is the reason? Whatever you feel like, say it. What can be the reason? What do you think? Galat ho jayega, bolo to sahi. What do you think? Yes. Vinod. Mrs. Darling was using the things, that's why. Very good. Yes, Ramanjeet. Mrs. Due to Mrs. Darling, yes, Raghav. थैंक जंग लग गया यहाँ पे मुझे लग रहा है घर बैठ के नहीं वो रिस्पॉन्स ही नहीं आई वॉन्ट इंटरक्टिव सेशन ऑलवेज द चिल्ड्रन शुड स्पीक दे शुड पार्टिसिपेट गलत बोलो बोलो तो सही कुछ यस जैकलिन व्हाट डू यू थिंक व्हाई डिडंट शी वेट ओवर देयर टू लुक हैव अ लुक ऑन द थिंग्स शी मूव्ड ऑन आई गिव यू वन एग्जाम्पल You have a beautiful room, ठीक है आपके बचपन के toys वहां पे पड़े हैं shelf पे you have kept it in a nobody will touch my toy, my teddy is there on this shelf, fine then you have old memories suppose आपकी कोई drawings है बचपन की आपने बनाई हुई है that you have pasted on a wall, ठीक है we are so particular we are so object oriented, fine तो आप अपने room में ऐसे रखा हुआ है then suddenly you sell out that home you shift to new home ठीक है आप नए होम में चले गए हो लेकिन वो स्टिल वहीं पे सब कुछ लगा हुआ है देन यू स्टार्ट मिसिंग एंड यू से टू योर पेरेंट्स दैट आई वांट टू विजिट माय ओल्ड होम मुझे जाना है वहां पे एक बार चाहे आप शिफ्ट हो रहे हो व्हेन यू गो ओवर देयर अ न्यू पर्सन हैज कम फाइन उसने आपका पेंटिंग वहां से रिमूव कर दिया है फाइन या कहीं और लगा दिया उठा के Your things in different setting, used by a different person, you will not feel like entering the place even, though that belonged to you once, because you do not have the authority now. Fine, number one. Number two, the same things are set in different way. That is the reason, setting is changed. So you do not feel belongingness, jo pehle aati thi, warmth. That is the main reason. Fine. So, let's read. Do you still know me? I asked. The woman looked at me searchingly. She had opened the door a chink. A chink means a little bit. A part of it. She did not open the complete door. A part of it she opened. And Mrs. S. daughter asked, Do you still know me? Who opened the door? Mrs. Darling. I came closer and stood on the step. आए कौन है यहाँ पे हु इज द नरेटर ऑफ द स्टोरी डॉटर ऑफ मिसेस एस नो आई डोंट नो यू आई एम मिसेस एस डॉटर शी हेल्ड हर हैंड ऑन द डोर एज दो शी वांटेड टू प्रिवेंट इट ओपनिंग एनी फर्दर आफ्टर लिसनिंग टू दिस शी यू नो योर जेस्टर स्पीक लाउडर देन योर वर्ड्स योर एक्शन स्पीक्स लाउडर सो शी वॉज एडमेंट आप किसी के घर पे जाओ रिलेटिव के वो डोर ही ना खोले थोड़ा सा खोले हाँ जी बताओ किसको मिलना है फाइन चाहे उसका डॉटर हो आपको पेरेंट को मिलना है एंड यू विल फील की एम्बेरस की दिस इज एन अटर इंसल्ट दे आर नॉट लेटिंग मी इन यू विल स्टेप डाउन एंड यू विल गो बैक ऑब्वियसली सो शी वाज नॉट ओपनिंग द डोर एंड शी वांटेड टू प्रिवेंट इट ओपनिंग एनी फर्दर हर फेस गेव एब्सोल्युटली नो साइन ऑफ रिकॉग्निशन शी डिड नॉट रिकॉग्नाइज दैट गर्ल शी केप्ट स्टेयरिंग एट मी इन साइलेंस स्टेयरिंग मींस लुकिंग स्टेडिली Perhaps I was mistaken. तो उसको लगा कि शायद मैं तो नहीं गलत एड्रेस पे आ गई It can be my mistake also. I thought perhaps it is not her. I had seen her only once. So now she is going to tell us that she has not seen Mrs. S. Mrs. Darling a number of times. ठीक है तो उसने कुछ एक बार ही देखा है उसको कहती maybe I have mistaken. This is someone else. And that was years ago. It was most probable that I had rung the wrong bell. She thought I am at the wrong address. The woman let go of the door and stepped to the side. Now, daughter of Mrs. S, she realized something that she was wearing my mother's green knitted cardigan. Knitted cardigan. The wooden buttons were rather pale from washing. धो के उसके वुडन बटन्स भी पेल हो चुके थे शी वॉज एबल टू रिकॉग्नाइज दैट शी इज वेयरिंग माई मदर्स ग्रीन कार्डिगन शी सॉ दैट आई वॉज लुकिंग एट द कार्डिगन एंड हाफ हिड हर सेल्फ अगेन बिहाइंड द डोर फर्स्टली शी केम इन फ्रंट ऑफ हर एंड देन शी रियलाइज ओके शी इज लुकिंग एट माई कार्डिगन कहीं इसने पहचान तो नहीं लिया Fine, she again got hesitated and she again tried to hide herself behind the door. Who is hiding behind the door? Mrs. S. Mrs. Darling. Who? Mrs. Darling. Don't get confused, okay? So Mrs. Darling was hiding behind the door. But I knew now that I was right. Now the confusion was clear that this is not someone else. This is same lady I was searching for. Well, you knew my mother, I asked. Again, she asked, have you come back? See, pehle wo lady keh rahi hai, I don't know you. Now she's asking, have you come back? Ab wapis aa gaye ho? I thought that no one had come back, only me. So this was the answer, that nobody had come back. Means why? Because her mother is actually no more, that we'll get to know at the end. A door opened and closed in the passage behind her. A musty smell emerged. I regret, I cannot do anything for you. So when she opened the half door, she was getting a smell, something was being poked inside. And she said that, I am sorry, I cannot do anything for you. So she did not recognize her. I have come here specially on the train. Daughter said that itni dur se main aayi hu. I wanted to talk to you for a moment. It is not convenient for me now. That was the answer. See how people change. Usi ka ghar, usi ki cheeze, and she's not able to recognize. I can't see you another time. Kabhi aur aana, I'm busy. She nodded and cautiously closed the door as though no one inside the house should be disturbed. Usko tha, mere ghar walon ko bhi nahi pata lag jaye that somebody has come. In a very, silent manner, she closed the door. Clear to everyone? I stood where I was on the step. The curtain in front of the bay window moved. Someone stared at me and would then have asked what I wanted. Oh, nothing. The woman would have said it was nothing. So she was able to perceive that curtain was moving and somebody was looking at her still. And again, someone stared at me and would then have asked. I looked at this. She wanted to reassure herself. Ki, am I at the wrong address? Kya ho raha hai? Again, she looked at the nameplate. Darling, it said in black letters on white enamel. White color ki plate ke upar kya likha tha? Darlings. And on the jamb, a bit higher, the number. Number was, 46. मैंने गलत लिख दिया यहाँ पे, काफी देर बाद ये चैप्टर पढ़ाया. दिस इज 46, मेक द करेक्शन बेटा. 46. एज आई वॉक्ड स्लोली बैक टू द स्टेशन, आई थॉट अबाउट माय मदर. नाउ दैट वाज द प्रेजेंट मोमेंट. शी केम, शी नॉक्ड एट द डोर, शी मेट द वुमन, शी डिड डिनाई टू रिकॉग्नाइज हर. नाउ शी विल बी गोइंग बैक टू हर पास्ट. When she is going back to the railway station, ab uski past memories linger on hoengi. Clear? I thought about my mother who had given me the address years ago. It had been in the first half of the war. I was home for a few days and it struck me immediately that something or other about the rooms had changed. Now she is talking about when war was going on. And daughter of Mrs. S used to remain out for education. And whenever she would come back home, she would find things missing at her own home. Jab wo wapis aati thi, during the war time, I'm talking. So she says that whenever I would come back, I would ask that something is changed. Kya change ho gaya? I missed various things. My mother was surprised I should have noticed so quickly. And mother of this girl, she would say that how smart you are. Every time you come, you immediately notice. Then she told me about Mrs. Darling. Then she got to know. Okay, during the childhood days. I had never heard of her, but apparently she was an old acquaintance, jaan pehchan, of my mother, whom she had not seen for years. She had suddenly turned up and renewed their contact. Since then, she had come regularly. So now background story goes on. When Mrs. S was there and war was going on, Mrs. Darling would visit them and she would take all the objects, one or the other objects, unke ghar se, And daughter of Mrs. S used to remain outside for education. When she would come back, she would notice. Every time she leaves here, she takes something home with her, said my mother. She took all the table silver in one go. Underline this, those who are having book, those who do not have, write down. क्या क्या लेके गई थी वो उनके घर से. She took all the table silver in one go. टेबल के ऊपर जो जो भी इनका सिल्वर ऑब्जेक्ट्स पड़े थे और कटलरी और वट एवर यूटेंसिल्स एंड ऑल, टेबल सिल्वर इन वन गो. एंड देन शी टुक द एंटीक प्लेट्स. एंटीक मीन बिलोंगिंग टू ओल्ड टाइम्स, यू नो एंटीक चीजें ज्यादा महंगी होती हैं. सो एंटीक प्लेट्स वर देयर, शी टुक दैट. नेक्स्ट शी हैड ट्रबल लगिंग दोज लार्ज वॉसेस, बड़े बड़े वॉसेस जो फूलदान होते हैं, शी टुक दोज इन अ वेरी ट्रबल सम वे, फिर भी लेके गई. I am worried she got a crick in her back from the crockery. Kehti main kehti thi ki uske back pe pain nahi hua, hamara sara samaan utha utha ke leke gayi hai. That she would feel very bad and she would say to her mother that why she is carrying our things. My mother shook her head pityingly. I would never have dared ask her. She suggested it to me herself. So her mother was so innocent. She says to her daughter that, you know, Mrs. Darling has given this suggestion to me that I would take care of your things, and that's why she is taking everything. She even insisted, she wanted to save all my nice things. She gave the suggestions ki jo bhi mehengi mehengi achhi achhi cheeze hai na, I will take care of it. War like circumstances, nobody knows what will happen. If we have to leave here, we shall lose everything, she says. So that was the suggestion given by Mrs. Darling, that if you stay here, you will lose everything. So better whenever you will be leaving. But now background of the war, Holland ka agar aap padhoge na, you will get to know. Why Mrs. S is leaving? Why Mrs. Darling is not leaving? Nobody asked me. Huh? Yes, very good. Because there was a particular community, those who were at the target of people. So she belonged to Jewish community. They have not mentioned it anywhere. But in the when you search for the war of Holland, Jewish people were asked to move out of the place. Jaise Indians ko Pakistan walon ne wahan se nikal diya tha. Yes, Nazis invasion, German camp, and you might have read about it in SST. So when that invasion is interference of the one country into the other, then they force a particular community to leave. Yehi to problem hai India ka. Those we are multi-secular people, but even then the problem goes on and on. It's never about, it should be about people. Problem should be about human beings. But yahan pe problem kya aata hai? Religion, one religion versus another religion. Self-created hate. खुद से ही क्रिएट कर देते, इसने ऐसे किया, उसने वैसे किया, एंड वन थिंग लीड्स टू द होल कम्युनिटी स्टैंड्स एज इफ दे हैव सीन द एक्ट. अभी भी ऐसे ही होता है रोड्स पे, यू सी दैट एनी पेटी थिंग हैपेंस, दे टेक इट ऑन अ रिलीजियस लेवल. फाइन, सो दैट इज द रीजन. नाउ शी वॉज फोर्स बिकॉज शी वॉज बिलोंगिंग टू ज्यूश कम्युनिटी एंड शी हैड टू लीव. मिसेस डार्लिंग वॉज नॉट. So she took the advantage. वो कहती आपको तो निकाल देंगे, let me take all the beautiful things and costly things, ताकि आपकी बची तो रहेंगी चीजें. And have you agreed with her that she should keep everything? I asked. So now she, when she is recalling this daughter, when she went to that address, she could not enter into the house. She had to go back. While going back to railway station, she is missing those. Recalling those memories. Is it clear that how I asked my mother that why you are giving, and then she told me ki haan, there is one Mrs. Darling, she has suggested me and she will take care of these things. And usne pucha, mother, have you agreed? How can you be agreed to this thing? As if that's necessary, my mother cried. Her mother would cry ki ab main kuch kar hi nahi sakti hu. It would simply be an insult to talk like that. And think about the risk she is running each time she goes out of our door with a full suitcase or bag. Uski mother itni achhi thi, she would say, Mrs. S, that she is taking risk for us. Mrs. Darling carries a big suitcase from a person who has to leave the country. It is a risk for her, not for us. So ek to hamari wo cheeze le rahi hai, you should be thankful to that lady. So that was a good gesture by the mother. Okay, itna clear hai sabko beta. I'm going to end the meet. Bell ho chuki hai.